Welcome to This Is My Architecture. My name is Ran, and with me today is Cedric from Amdocs. Hi, Cedric.
Hi, how are you?
Great, thank you. Tell us a bit about Amdocs.
So Amdocs, it's a software and service provider which are providing solutions for communication, telcos, or media companies over the world. We have more than 300 customers among 80 countries.
Okay, great. So tell us what we're looking at here.
So what we are looking at here is actually MS 360, microservices 360 environment. This framework, okay, is actually dealing with all the infrastructure in order to have environment for production, for testing, for development, and in different kind of configurations.
Okay, so what are the different components here?
So you have here on top the layer which will deliver, actually create the environment and provision the software inside it. So we have all the functional components which are implementing the business logic are deployed in a Kubernetes environment or an EC2, depending if they are microservices or if actually they are less modular architecture. Mm-hmm. And below you have what we call the backing services layer, when you have all the persistence aspect. So NoSQL, SQL, messaging with Kafka, and then you have logging and monitoring items below.
Okay, so what is the flow like when a developer or a dev team wants to get an environment in order to test a new version of their application, let's say CRM or something like that?
So actually the kind of application we are deploying is CRM, is billing, invoicing, and things like that, right? Mm-hmm. So the first thing is that the operator will have to create an environment, mm-hmm. either for developers or for the production environment. Obviously, the difference would be the size, because for production, we can deal with 100 million subscribers, for instance. And for testing, we will deal with much less workload in terms of usage of the platform. So the thing is here is that the operator will actually create the environment using CloudFormation, and will use Jenkins to actually provision all the software like containers or VMs on EC2 instance. Mm-hmm. Right? And this is the CD part, and all the containers or the software that was been built by Amdocs before will be delivered to the Jenkins instance here using a repository such as Nexus or Artifactory or
S3. Okay. So the operator actually deploys a CloudFormation template, and then that deploys Jenkins and deploys the environment itself?
So CloudFormation will create this kind of environment here, right?
Yep.
Plus the backing services as we mentioned here. We can have multiple environments like this. And then Jenkins with provisions of software like this.
Okay, so microservices, deploying applications, developers being able to test their applications in a really agile way. This is quite an evolution from how software used to be delivered to telco companies and organizations like that. Tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, exactly. It's a revolution because now we have something which is much more modular. We can actually use managed services that are already there, already replicated and resilient, etc. We also have different kind of workloads we can have on business logic, either microservices or not. And we can create multiple environments on the fly, on demand according to the need of the telco, for instance. Mm. Right. So also what is interesting here is that we are using Kubernetes, and we are using tools which are open source tools such as Prometheus or Elasticsearch and Kafka. And then actually Prometheus will help us to have all the monitoring metrics from the different workload, and to actually send this workload to a tool such as CloudWatch will give you a complete view of all the DevOps ecosystem.
Okay, so then each team or each dev team actually uses the same kind of open source tools. For example, if they need to do event-driven work, they'll use Kafka. If they need to use other stuff like a relational database, they'll use RDS. So you're standardizing on the way that developers use the platform and deliver their software.
Exactly. We are standardizing all the DevOps ecosystem from devs to ops, right? But also more than that, we are actually providing clear interfaces for all the telcos to actually interface and use the environment.
Great. So once the environment is deployed at a telco, for example, a production environment, the subscribers actually go in and start using those applications.
Yep, exactly.
How does that look?
So these guys are actually the subscribers and users, and think about having maybe 10 or 100 millions of them, right? And here we have a business critical platform that will deal with all the mobile subscription of these guys, and you can scale according to your need in an automatic fashion.
Great. I really like the robustness and the way that this architecture is modular. It seems like you really made a great evolution in how we deliver software into telco companies.
Right, exactly. And I think what is good as well is that, as you can see with AWS, we can use standard tools. We can have a platform which can be deployed on-premise on AWS. But with AWS, we will leverage from the tools that are already there, open source tools with standard APIs.
Yeah, so if the customer or your dev environments are running on AWS, you can use managed services and even cut down the deployment time further.
Yeah, exactly.
Great. Thanks a lot for sharing.
Thank you, Ron.
Thank you. And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.